बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम इय्याका नअबुदु व इय्याका नस्तईन अल्लाहुम्मा सल्ली अला मुहम्मदिन व अला आले मुहम्मदिन व बारिक सल्लम सल्ली। डियर कोलीग्स, दिस इज फीमेल मिडल एज्ड पेशेंट विच हु इज कंप्लेंटिंग ऑफ पॉलीमेनोरेजिया। Menses are much more increased during the first 4 or 5 days. The cycle is regular and also she has been married for the last 22 years and she had no pregnancy during these years. So also it is a case of infertility and polymenorrhagia. Here this is the uterus . We can appreciate that this uterus is bulky and enlarged in size, and if we closely observe, this is the endometrium which has indistinct border. We cannot clearly differentiate the borders of the endometrium, and if we closely observe, there are linear striations which are hypoechoic, extending from the endometrium to the myometrium. We can see it waterfall effect or rain shower. And the uterus is coarse in aquatexture. It is not smooth, rather it is coarse. We can say it in a broad term, the cirrhosis of the uterus. And here also we can see that there is no distinct mass, no discrete mass which would have clear-cut borders or marginated borders. No well-defined mass is seen. Overall, uterus is bulky. Here, this is the endometrium, but when we go upward, the endometrium has indistinct border, and this hypoechoic lines are present along the from the endometrium to the posterior wall and from the endometrium to the anterior wall. And also we can see that the myometrium is bulky. It has increased thickness and bulky more on the posterior side than on the anterior side. Here we can clearly appreciate the endometrium, but here this has become indistinct. No clear-cut border could be recognized. So in my opinion, this is the case of adenomyosis of the uterus. If we go for the differential, then we can say that this may be the leiomyomatosis of the uterus, but this is less likely. The most likely diagnosis is adenomyosis of the uterus. what happened in the adenomyosis, the endometrial glands or tissues, they directly invade the myometrium, resulting in the neovascularity or angiogenesis of the spiral arteries within the myometrium. And also there occurs hyperplasia and hypertrophy of the smooth muscle of the myometrium. So when the hypertrophic muscles are present within the myometrium, they surround the endometrial tissue, which is ectopically located or ectopically invaded the myometrium. They constrict the or tamponade the these arteries, resulting in the increased menstrual cycle. In my opinion, this is likely to be the adenomyosis with indistinct margin of the endometrial tissue, bulkiness of the myometrium along the anterior and posterior uterine wall, as well as the waterfall effect or rain shower effect, which are these linear striations, hypoechoic striations extending from the endometrium to the anterior and posterior uterine wall. For confirmation or for further evaluation, we can also go for the MRI pelvis plane, which can also show the widening of the junction zone between the endometrium and the myometrium. So this was an interesting case. I want to show you how we can differentiate from the leiomyoma to that of adenomyosis. So this is likely to be the adenomyosis of the uterus. This was an interesting case. I like to share you people. Actually, most of the time the adenomyosis occurs due to some procedure like caesarean section, DNC, dilatation and curettage of the uterus. This patient is also giving the history of DNC. And after the DNC, this condition has been faced by the patient in shape of increased menstrual cycle, dysmenorrhea, and also still she is infertile, no pregnancy is there in the past years. So this was an interesting case. I am sharing you people. Kindly comment on the any other pathological condition or any other differential which you have in your mind. Thank you very much. One card. I don't know.